Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to verify a trig identity using the basic identities and the identity for the cosine of a sum or difference. So here's our problem. Cosine of x plus y over cosine x cosine y equals 1 minus tangent x times tangent y. All right, well, what we could do is start with one side and just keep simplifying to see if we get the other side. Another way of doing an identity is drawing a line under them and the equal sign here and just working on one side to see if you can get the other side. But if not, you could also work on the other side. So let's start on the left-hand side. I see I've got the cosine of x plus y. Let's use the identity for the cosine of x plus y. That'll be cosine x, cosine y, minus sine x, sine y. And that's all over cosine x, cosine y. All right. Now, what we have is a difference in the numerator over one term in the denominator, so we could split the numerator up, and that'll give me cosine x, sorry, cosine y over cosine x, cosine y minus the second term up there, sine x. Sine y over cosine x cosine y. All right, so let's look at the first fraction. We've got cos x cos y over cos x cos y. Well, that's going to be 1. That's going to completely cancel, right? 1 over 1. So that'll give me a 1 minus, and what do I have here? I have a sine x over cosine x, and I have a sine y over cosine y. So the sine x over cosine x, if you want to show that separately first, you could say this is the sine x over cosine x times the sine y over the cosine y. Gotta be careful how you write it. And that is sine x over cosine x is tangent x, and sine y over cosine y is tangent y. So we have just verified this identity. This is the more formal way of showing the proof. Notice the only difference is here's the problem, prove in green, and then what you do is you decide which side you're going to work on. So you would write down one of the sides, which I'll use the left side. You write equal, and then you start simplifying until you make it look like the right-hand side. So there's just different formats for showing a proof. This is often how it's done in books. It's a more formal way in mathematics to show it. The problem is sometimes you might get stuck on a step, and it might be hard to make it look exactly like the other side. Whereas if we do it the other way, right here, what you could do is take the right-hand side if you got stuck and tried simplifying that. It might look slightly different. For instance, you would be allowed to do something like this. You could write 1 minus sine x cosine x times sine y, cosine y. You might have done that first. So when you got to this point here on the left-hand side, you would have said it already looks like the right-hand side. So two different formats of showing exactly the same proof. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.